up, everybody? We are looking at my $9.99 eBay purchase for a PUPPYOO wireless upright vacuum cleaner, model WP511. I'm honestly surprised that they even shipped this for $10. I would assume shipping itself would have cost at least $10, if not $20, for an item this size. So yeah, I figured, you know, I saw for 10 bucks. I think they were normally asking like 60 to 80 for this thing. So I don't know if they just wanted to clear them out or if it's a price mistake or what, but for 10 bucks, I'm like, you know what? I have to buy this just to try it out on this channel. We'll see if it's just a cheap Chinese super no-name vacuum is going to be good at all. And I don't know. I just thought it'd be an interesting video. So in this video, we're going to unbox it, see everything you get for 10 bucks. It's not currently $10 anymore. They sold out super quick, as you can imagine. And this was probably 3 weeks ago, so it took a little while to get here. So let's go ahead and cut into it. Not really much info on the box itself. Here's some specs. Not much info there. And let's see what you get for $10. Sorry, the box is quite large, so I have to do this sideways until I get my new setup ready. Alright, I'll pull it down and then I'll show you guys what I pull out. So, you get a bolt set that's going to attach your handle to the main unit. Most upright vacuums have that. And this even has one of those cutting tools for when hair gets trapped on the brush roll. It makes it a lot easier to get out. And then, of course, a manual. Dear friend, thank you for buying PUPPYOO over other brands. Sorry, I only bought you because you're 10 bucks. You get a tool here. Let's see, it pulls out. Yeah, pretty standard tool. It comes with most vacuums. Charging cable. That is it. That's all that comes in the box. Alright, looks like you push this and then that will release it. And there you go, now you have your handheld vac. Where it connects to the upright vacuum and then sends power down to the brush roll. Of course, it has a filter. And a pretty good sized dirt bin. And then I'll just put this through a quick review. I'll use it in the handheld mode. And then I'll hook it up to this guy and we'll see how well this cleans. Honestly, I expect it to clean decent. I mean, for 10 bucks, I don't think you can lose. Let me know down in the comments if you guys would have ordered something like this if you saw it for a whopping $10. Too good to pass up, I think. I know this isn't very impressive or really what I typically do on this channel, but like I said, I felt like why not just show it to you guys, see if a really cheap, crappy, no-name, well, I can't call it crappy yet because I haven't tested it, but a really cheap, no-name vacuum, if it's worth it whatsoever. Do me a favor, if you're new, please like and subscribe, and let me know you guys want to see. All right, guys, I left this charging overnight, and yeah, now I see why it's $9.99. As you see, it's been flashing like this all night. Looking like it's charging, right? But guess what? Absolutely nothing. So I paid $10, which was nothing, of course, but it doesn't work at all. So, since this video's a dud, thought, why not go ahead and take this little guy apart real quick and see what is even inside of a $10 piece of junk. I mean, it feels heavy duty. It's nice and heavy. You can tell it has a decent motor. Let me grab a screwdriver. We're going to take that apart real quick. Nope, I already loosened that. It just wasn't loose enough. There we go. Let's see what's inside of this. There's all the connections. They look to be intact. Here's the motor, suction motor. So there's the plug. I wonder why this guy isn't charging. It might just be really old stock or something. The battery's no good anymore or something like that. Could be a lot of things. But so that's the power button there. I'm just gonna wind up trashing this. I'm not worried about the $10, I guess, but it's too much hassle to get the $10 back. So we'll just kind of mess with this and see what we can do with it. Deconstruction. Little tiny board that runs the entire thing. There's the little tiny motor that runs it. And here's the battery pack that failed, basically. This is probably more exciting than the vacuum would have been anyways. Battery pack is almost out. All right, no big deal. But there you have it. There's this exciting $10 vacuum from eBay. I'm pretty sure they were just getting rid of old stock, which at $10, I guarantee you that cost them more than $10 to ship that. You think they would have just trashed them all. And here's this piece of junk. Actually had LED lights and everything. What an epic piece of crap. Powerful cleaning brush. Yeah. I don't think you would have been very good overall, but that's okay. Alright guys, well, you know, obviously that video was kind of a dud, so that's why I wanted to just go and take it apart, kind of show you what's inside of it, and I'm just going to trash it, no sense in keeping it. I'll have a couple of shipping boxes out of it, whoop-de-doo. But yeah, I bought this just for the heck of it. Like I said earlier, it's $10. Why not try it? This is a vacuum channel. Ultimately, I either just got a random defective one, or I'm sure everybody that ordered one is probably having the same issue. These batteries are probably quite old. This product is probably pretty old, and they were just liquidating, getting rid of them all. And that's what you should get. Alright, if you enjoyed that video at all, do me a favor, like and subscribe. And I got some new videos coming very shortly. One of them is the Wise robot vacuum with LiDAR. I just got that in today, so that's going to be exciting to test that one out. I think it's going to be very good. And at $199, I'm hoping I can say this is the robot you need to be buying. Because right now, for a LiDAR-based robot that's cheap, Roborock kind of runs the market as far as quality. So can Wise be just as good? We'll find out soon. Thanks for watching. Have an awesome day, and we'll see you in the next one.